Modernizing your applications can be a very daunting task, even for a seasoned professional like myself. Now, what I wanted to share today is one of the principles of pets versus cattle, which has really helped me through my journey to refactoring. Now, let's start by breaking this down. So we have pets and cattle. Now, the usual understanding of this particular analogy refers to server management. If you think about the concept of a pet, we are interested in our pets completely. We are obsessed with nursing them, making sure they're well, you know, and the same thing with your servers. You will always be working with keeping them up and running, checking logs when they're a problem. I'm always concerned about root cause analysis of anything, but I am completely invested in the actual stability of that particular server. Now, when it comes to the cattle side, this is really a technique that's really done when you want to get into clustering and with Kubernetes. Let's do K8s. All right, what's more facilitated too, I'm not so much concerned about the individual components there. Servers are usually numbered, number 1, 2, 3. If one has a problem, I can remove them from that particular clustering or cluster Kubernetes instance deployment, and they get replaced by another component there. Now, why is this really important is because on the clustering side, we have inherent, especially with Kubernetes, we have inherent stability that's there. There's a certain resiliency to failure. There's an ability to do auto-scaling in that particular architecture that's there. Whereas on the pet side, this is pretty much, you could probably hear this done as a monolith. I am always responsible for my stability. If that resource goes down, that server goes down, we are lost. You know, something is not running anymore. Whereas on the other side with cattle is something described that can be resilient to failure. It will always be up and running, all right? So think about database servers, email servers, you know, these type of resources, or application servers, you know, it's really there. So it is on me to keep it up and running. Let's kind of flip this out. And this has been a useful technique that I've used to actually understand the process of modernizing your applications. And let's draw the line here as we start to understand this particular concept. And it starts off where, believe it or not, you have an application. All right. Every application, I believe, is going to start as what we call a monolith. All right. And the monolith is, you can probably describe this as an application with different modules. If I'm writing this, it's probably going to be one language that I'm going to be using because it's going to be one single code base. And believe it or not, every application really starts this way. I don't know many applications that start out on this particular corresponding architecture, which is, we'll call this distributed. All right, so monolith versus the distributed, which is probably cloud native. We could put that in parens there as well. So as a varying or opposing thing from this particular modular format that we have here, in this particular architecture, it is done from the ability of you to do, I'm going to go from one code base to multiple, taking those modules out, and I want them to be separate runtimes, all right? And which can be called microservices, all right? That's the MS in there, if you cannot see, all right? We'll just say M there. But we really mean them to be microservices, where they generally have one responsibility, one job to do that we can then pull together to meet that different, that application, whatever it should be, all right? And that inherently becomes a cloud-native application from that architecture here. This also gives me the opportunity to implement a polyglot in my programming here or architecture here, where I can now use multiple languages to accomplish that. I have the ability to explore to say for that single responsibility that just a particular microservice have, is there another code base that will really kind of give me that a better performance here, because now I'm concerned with each individual component doing their job to make this piece work together. And that's how inherently you have that resiliency, because every little piece does their core job and they can be also scaled out to handle their particular piece there. Whereas on this side, it's a little bit harder to do any of this because I'm always responsible for, if I change any of these, everything has to change. I have to check everything else here. All right, so monolith to cloud native, all right, a common pattern there. And as we mentioned, these particular pieces, we can also say there is the concept of the middleware, which can be responsible for connecting those individual pieces or give me additional functionality there. We talk about messaging, or we want to get into Kafka, all right, to add these individual pieces for real-time event-driven architectures here as well. When we get to this particular piece, for those other components, non-code pieces here, there's a different concept when it comes to modernizing there. Again, as I start to work with things, I'm going to be concerned with configuring that particular piece to grow, and it can be monolithic in nature by me making one instance handle a large load of that particular functionality there. Whereas on the other side of that, kind of the layer I want to get to is the ability to actually say I want to have that same piece, but I want it to be compatible with a DevOps circumstance here. Well, I want to replicate that on a smaller scale, all right? And that comes by now having individual pieces that I want to be replicated or templated. And that's going to really be done by taking the configuration of that. You'll hear this a lot where we say the configuration, but it corresponds to the config as code. So in your project, I want you to kind of start to analyze how you can implement refactoring of your application. One important concept to know that is not a versus this here. It is a combined strategy. There are going to be some things that will stay as monoliths or singular entities or your pets that you take care of, and some parts of your application that can be in a distributed nature where you want that resiliency, that abilities for auto-scaling and just to be up and running. That's really the core principle of modernizing now. And this has been a principle that's been so useful to me. I love to hear your experiences on how you're implementing this or how you've done your own refactoring in your own applications. As always, technically yours, Senior Espana.